为什么中国人至今对诺尔曼·白求恩大夫仍怀有深厚感情？加拿大中国友好协会多伦多分会主席沃伦·白求恩近日在多伦多接受中新社记者专访时，做出了自己的回答。
So how do we commemorate him? As you can see, we commemorate him in many different ways. So that's sincere. So we don't do it every year in a tomb. You know, in terms of thinking, in terms of his death. We think of it in terms of his life. The generation before, Western countries were looking to dominate Chinese people. Dr. Norman found, with teaching, empowered them. So that gave them hope, and that encouraged development, which continued, obviously to today.
他认为，白求恩大夫的贡献，正如毛泽东所说，一个外国人毫无利己的动机，把中国人民的解放事业当作他自己的事业。沃伦这样诠释白求恩精神。
There's nothing greater than that, to if you're willing to risk your life for other people's liberation, if other people are willing to risk their life to enable you to do your job, there's nothing higher than that. People coming up with more greater insights as to why the Chinese people have such deep respect and regard and warmth, and why he for the Chinese people. So the journey continues.
如今的中加关系面临困难，沃伦认为，要了解真实的中国，需要眼见为实。
And I would.To get a, we'll say a 360-degree impression, I would need to go there and see for myself. I believe if the people visited, that the general impression would be positive of China if they got an opportunity to visit.
沃伦说，他也了解到，商界、教育界、文化界都在继续推动双边交往。面对新冠疫情，中加双方也都相互给予过支持。他相信，双方需要在经济和文化领域建立更多交集。作为加中友协多伦多分会负责人，沃伦表示，协会需要让各种背景的人们了解白求恩大夫的重要性以及他对中国的贡献，了解加中关系的更多点点滴滴。
I plan to do it, so it, when I do hand it off, that.Things are better than they are now, and that both Canadians and Chinese people look at each country as friends. So that's as they do in the daily life. And so I'm looking to expand, obviously, the people-people relationships that actually do exist. And the part of the Friendship Association is to highlight some of those relationships that exist.
沃伦说，自己看到中国的巨大飞跃是了不起和令人惊叹的。
China should be proud that they've raised the people out of poverty. They should be proud of that, because that's the most people lifted out of poverty ever in history.
沃伦认为，中国在住房、交通、教育等领域不断改善人民生活质量。而当人们谈论人工智能、可再生能源等概念时，其实也是在探讨改善人的生活。他说，西方也有其为之骄傲的历史，西方与中国应该开放、互学、互鉴，不同社会制度都应具有的目标是照顾人的基本需求，扩大人与人之间的交流，促进和平与发展。